What's good, Bully World? This is Zeb. I'm your host, Bully Talk with Zeb Pitts. And today you're tuned in to Weekend in Review. Let's start it off. Let's head out there to Bel Air, Maryland. Bully Roots Reunion number 7. At that particular show, your boy was surprised with a Merit of Honor award. I was very humbled by that. I really appreciate that. I received that from Pat of Jam Pack Pits and Anchorage Awards. Not only myself did I receive the award, Norman Forrest also received the award, and Ran of Bullypedia also received that award. And let's check out that clip of me receiving that Merit of Honor award.
Oh, there you go. Oh, you got me.
Here, I'll hold this.
How do you do it? Zeb, you gotta turn it on, remember?
It's on. It's on.
Oh, it's like it's rainy again.
Alright, this is Maryland, and we have a fellow Maryland native who is worthy of being Merit of Honor. And you know, this guy's been day in, day out. I keep saying that word, but he always bringing the news, bringing what's hot and what's not. He doesn't care if controversial or not. He's going to find the bottom of it. He's going to bring the media, the public, everything you want to hear. The guy's got a solid backbone and stands up for everything this bullying group and this community is about. So today, on behalf of Jam Packed Events, I want to give it to my good friend, fellow colleague, everything.
Once again, I just want to say thank you to Pat, Jam Pack Pitts, and Anchorage Awards for receiving that honor. I was very humbled by that first award I ever received in the bully world, and I really appreciate that. It was very humbling to receive that in my own backyard in Maryland at the show with a lot of people there that I knew. It was a good look for me, a good moment, man, and I really appreciate that. Let's do the rundown now of that particular show. At that particular show, under Derek Dennis, we had a grand champion, Azul, who took Best in Show under Derek Dennis. Congratulations. He's out of the Baltimore, Maryland area. Bad boy and grand champion, Azul. Next, in the second show, under Lou Manipal, that boy, grand champion, The Bear. That's a bad boy right there, man. He took Best in Show in the second show. And in the third show under John Ronica, that girl, She-Male, one of the baddest bitches in the bully world, Man Up Boys, owned by my man Donald Holmes, took Best in Show in show number 3, and also at that particular show there in Maryland, received the title of Grand Champion. She is now Grand Champion, Man Up Boys. Congratulations, Mr. Holmes, on that accomplishment. One of the baddest bitches in the game that I've ever seen, man, for real, real talk. Also, at that particular show at the Bully Roots Reunion number 7, of course I gave out the Dog of the Day award. That went to Grand Champion, The Bear. Let's check it out and see me giving out that award to Grand Champion, The Bear. What's good, Bully World? It's Zeb, your host, Bully Talk with Zeb Pitts, and we about to give out the Bully Talk Zeb Pitts dog of the day right here. Let's see who's about to take it out here at the Bully Roots Reunion number 7. All right, I got my girls behind the mic. Follow me. And they are the first Bully Talk Zeb Pitts dog of the day, two-time winner.
With that boy the bear.
Female from the state of Maryland. We got a female dog from the state of Maryland. Bring them all over here. So how this is going to work is bring them all
over here. Congratulations, man.
Yeah, mom's going to be happy. That's for you, Mom.
Now this is going to work.
You got it on there?
Uh-huh. All right, for you. First
two-time winner of the Bully Talk Zeb Pitts dog of the day. We're about to go over here and take a little quick photo with all the awards he got so far. Still one more show left, though. One more show left. But we're about to take some quick photos.
That's that boy right there.
This king is this King Maryland Award. Every year, winners.
Once again, I want to say congratulations to Grand Champion the Bear on being a two-time winner of the Bully Talk Zeb Pitts Dog of the Day. It was very close, man. It was real close. I was real close to giving it up to Man Up Boys, owned by Donna Holmes, with that bad female and that he has, man. Very close. I can definitely see Man Up Boys taking home that Bully Talk Zeb Pitts Dog of the Day Award sometime soon. It was very close. And I just want to say congratulations to all the bad bullies out there at the show. If you get a chance, I did a couple of videos. A little something playing around with. I did a video for Grand Champion the Bear. Also did a video for Scribble. One of the baddest Frenchies in the game out there. You got to definitely check that out. And also a video for Man Up Boys. So, let's check out little snippets of each one of the videos right now. Some bad bullies that we got in the bully world. Also, I want to say congratulations to Logan Jones, ABKC Junior Handler, took the first show Best Junior Handler first show and second in the second show. And I just want to say congratulations to Logan on that. And matter of fact, let's check out a little clip of a little piece of the interview that I did with him also as well. And I just once again want to say congratulations. I see big things coming for him. Definitely great to see competition among the junior handlers, especially with him, Destiny Myers, the Cruz Boys, Mike Rua's daughter. So it's great to see that going on in the junior handler world. You know, it's the future is definitely bright in the ABKC. Let's check it out.
What's good, Bully World? I'm over here with my man Logan. What's going on, man?
Not much, sir.
What have you done so far today?
I took best of the best junior handler for show one on the day. And American Pitbull Terrier took best of breed. And our champion Silverboy took champion Saber and best of breed. And Pack Lunch, our shorty bull, she took first place and was our best winner.
Let me ask you, what was your inspiration to get into showing the handle?
First show ever, I just watched the dog and the handler, and I just seen a connection with it. And I've always loved dogs since I was a very young age. And I just thought I've wanted to go at it and maybe have that connection with my dogs. And it's really helped me along to hopefully go to vet school and hopefully have a great life ahead of me.
Who are some of the people you look up to in the bully community as far as a handler?
Mr. Anthony Gray. You sometimes, because you actually show videos on YouTube, and I'll see the different dogs and I'll see the different styles. Christopher Bully the Kid, he really inspirational. Pure Country Kennels, they really helped me out a lot, and Bo Stevenson.
So what's the goal for 2017?
Hope for number one junior handler, sir.
Wow. Well, so what do you think about Destiny Myers?
She's really hard competition. She's really good at this. And I'm just hoping that I can do just a little bit better, put in a little bit more work maybe, and hopefully I'll be able to take it sometimes.
How was it when you have the head-to-head competition with her?
It's really hard because I know she knows her stuff and she's really good at it, but I've been working hard, and it's just really a battle against each other to see what the judges would think of us, and it just depends sometimes.
So are you looking forward to Nationals this year?
Yes, sir.
That's right. Who are you going to be handling in Nationals?
I believe I'll be showing Karma, which is our champion Saverboy, or maybe Grand Champion Mosifus, maybe.
Maybe. That's what's up. Good luck on the next two shows today.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Take care. That's Logan. Are you on Facebook or anything, Logan?
Yes, sir.
I never know.
We have Team Logan and Logan Jones is me, and then Cindy Ken Jones is my dad and mom. And that's about it.
Well, that's what's up, man. Congratulations again.
Thank you, sir.
And that's what he took right here. Bully Roots Reunion number 7, Best Junior Handler. Show 1, correct? Show 1.
Once again, congratulations to Logan on your accomplishments at the Bully Roots Reunion number 7. Hey, let's check out this small clip from Peter Fell. I just ran across it, man. He got a bad bully, man. Check out this muscled up bully in this quick video that he did. Let's check it out. Man, I told you that was a bad bully. Oh man, I told you, man. Busted up everything. Phenomenal looking dog. Let's check out another video I ran across that week by Antonio Alexander. He got his bad bully grand champion, Nicky Jam, working out on the treadmill. Check out this bad boy right here. Told you grand champion Nicky Jam was a bad boy, man. Just strolling on that treadmill with the weight vest on, putting in that work. It's great to see bullies doing their thing, man. What else is going on in the weekend in review? Also got a chance to check out that video Bashar did of Grand ABKC Grand Champion Mr. Bing. That boy was looking good, man, looking bully as hell. Let's check out that video.
I don't think I've ever seen Bean run so fast.
Great looking muscle tone bully right there. Let's check out this small clip that I ran across by Nico of Rock Solid Style Bullies, man. You know, sometimes you're gonna have your ups and downs when it comes to this bully world. Matter of fact, in life in general. And he just gave a little quick 1 minute message talking about one of the harder moments and how you get through it. Let's check it out.
What's going on, Bully Fam? This is Nico, Rock Solid Style Bullies. Yeah, earlier today, my client called me from the Philippines, and he told me that, Nico, my litter dropped, and I have 9 puppies. But hours later, he called me back saying, like, Nico, I lost 6 of the 9 puppies. Man, this is sad, but we can't do anything about it anymore. So we got to keep moving, make sure the other puppies stay alive, and next time, use this as a learning experience that what our errors are and correct it. You know, this part of the game, there's an adversity that will keep you stronger. And moving forward, it will make you a better breeder. Because God got plans. Everything works in God's will, you know. If God hasn't answered a prayer right now, it doesn't mean that he isn't going to answer it ever. It's just that he hasn't answered it yet, but we gotta be thankful that he hasn't answered yet, because he has something better planned for us, you know? So you just gotta stay positive, keep your head up, and keep pushing, you know? You know, so, you know, bully game is so crazy, like, it just doesn't happen the way we planned it. So we just have to be always positive, you know? So we over here, Rock Solid Style Bullies. Kennel's already clean. The run, it's ready out of poop. So say hello to my doggies, man. They going home, man. They already ate. My doggies over there. Hey, no. All right, they poop. All right, guys, keep bully fam.
That was really powerful words right there, man. Much respect on that for doing that. Also, I had a chance when I went down to Virginia Beach over the weekend for that sit-down interview I was finally talking about that I was going to do with Antonio McClendon of the Potter House. Great interview, great guy. He has the baddest XLs in the world. Believe that. The baddest XLs in the world, hands down. And I can't think of any other person that I would want to recommend people for getting dogs. I mean, his facilities is a great facility, and puts in a lot of work with his dogs. And matter of fact, let's check out just a few other of the what I call moments in that interview. Matter of fact, the video is up now, but I just want to give like a couple of quick highlight moments of that interview. Check it out.
I do. So when you come to me to either purchase a puppy or to get tips on how to handle your dog, you're getting more than just a person who does dogs. You know, I am showing dogs and training dogs, that's just something that I enjoy doing. But it's not who I am.
You know,
it's not who I am. There are other things. There are other titles that come before dog man and breeder or dog handler. You know, there are definitely other titles that come before that that mean a whole lot more to me. You know, child of God. You know, being a father. You know, being a son, being a husband. Those titles to me are everything to me, and those titles help make me a great coach and a great dog handler or dog trainer. Those titles are what are my motivation.
I'm gonna ask you, man. You know, just give people who might be down and out and going through things. What's one of the toughest things that you had to deal with, and how did you overcome it?
I would say, you know, when my mom and my dad got a divorce, and, you know, not seeing them for, you know, 10 years of my life, I would probably say that was tough. You know, my mom remarried and married a great guy, and he's dad. You know, he took care of me like he was, you know, like he was the guy that made me, and I love him to death for that. But in the back of my mind, you know, it's always tough knowing that, you know, the guy who helped make you didn't honor the craft, you know, didn't honor that title of being dad and father. You know, it's, I think people, they take it for granted, you know, the effect that it can have on a young person's, on a person's life. And, you know, no matter how old they are, you know, fortunately for me now, you know, I was raised by a strong mother and a strong father, and they instill some things in me. And so now, you know, I use that tough obstacle that was hard for me to overcome, you know, growing up. I use that now, and I talk to young people that may be going through the same thing. And, you know, I can, in a sense, coach them through it and give them some tips and maybe some strategies that I use to help me get past it. And so that's it, you know. But, yeah, that was growing up without my biological father for at least 10 years of my life, man. It was that's tough. It was tough.
You can check out that full interview with Antonio McLennan on YouTube. Also, shout out to Caesar of the BBB clothing line, born to breed bully breeders, man. Thank you for the shirt that I received down at the Maryland show. Check it out. Hey, man, much respect on your clothing line, big dog, and I really appreciate it. Once again, shout out to Caesar, the BBB clothing line, and one of his newer shirts that he has out right now. I got to get a hat too, big dog. You know I'm a hat person, man. But check out the shirt. Much respect on that, man. Now, and this is that merit award that I was talking about that I received right here. Merit of Honor to whom honor is due, presented to Zeb Brooks, April 8th, 2017, Bully Roots Reunion number 7. Check it out. Yeah, I'm real proud of that, man. Much respect on that again. And that is pretty much it in your weekend in review. If you support Bully Talk with Zeb Pitts, man, please share. I put a lot of videos out this week, and it really takes a long time to sit there and put out that many videos. I don't think you understand the hours that it goes into to really putting videos together like that. And if you support the brand and support what I do in the bully world, please share on your page. Share, share, share. None of this is paid stuff, man. I do it for the love, man. And I would really appreciate, man, if you enjoy it, please share. And support the brand Bully Talk with Zaire Pitts. And I'll see you at the show soon. We out. Peace.